in all that pixelated glory. Well, let's go. Oh. Oh, there's a locked chapter. Huh. Okay. Yeah, basically the premise is you get to go through the lives of these three individuals. And I'm assuming that this is the chapter that you get once all three of their routes are finished. So who've we got? The best huntress in Windy Meadow, an aspiring bard, and a herbalist. Well, seeing as this is the M-Disc playlist, I feel obligated to start with the bard. 10 years ago, Little Oak Village. Ow! Listen, once we make a hole, we need to run. Do you understand? Don't take anything with you. What about Nanny? Who cares about Nanny? Nah, we can't look for her, honey. There's no time. Ooh, that doesn't sound good. We are not off to a good start at all. What can I do to help? Just look out for bandits. Fable, how close did the fire get? Is there a lot of smoke? Well, look around you! Do you not smell the smoke with all that fire? Oh, what the hell? Well, who just... Kid, you better get out of here. Or Dad, you better open up that door. Oh, shit! This was not at all how I was expecting this to start. God. What? Wait. You see all this bloodshed and fire, and all you can think about is needing a guide? Oh, at least you're... What? God damn, what the... Okay. I'm just trying to process all that just now. I feel like that's the quickest any game I've ever played has ever escalated, let alone a game I've recorded for this series. Okay. Point at a name that uses this color. I didn't get a chance to read it. Okay. Fate's sisters, husbands, mother, or something. Someone like that. She moved to Windy Meadow a year ago to... Thank you. To set her mind at ease, but I haven't found out what... my recorder's in the way. Exactly happened to her. She mostly sits in her house or travels to other villages, but Fate's... told me she's a smart person. I'm going to judge it myself. Okay, whatever. Daydreaming again? I was thinking about the last time I saw my parents in one piece. Learning is a never-ending process, dude. I'm still processing that prologue. God. Anyway, okay. Now let's focus on what we have in front of us. I try to write smaller letters, yet I never have enough space for them. Don't worry about it. Every beginner has this problem. Yep, that is definitely true. It's hard to plan how big your letters need to be and how to put them in an efficient order. Can't I use a bigger wax tablet? I'm sure Vates or Stabulous? The Fabulous Stabulous? It could be easier for you at first, but it would slow down your progress. Try to keep it up. Quick save. Okay. I'm trying, but washing off these old letters is really a pain. It takes up almost as much time as writing. It's a right fable. No need to rush anything. Well, we're rushing through the dialogue. No, at least it feels like we are. I need to learn, but Vates never has. Oh. A servant of God, a warrior, and my foster father. In this order. Yeah, he saved me. Can you stay up? Thank you. He saved me from bandits when I was 6 and brought me... Well, I don't know if I would call what I just saw saving. It seemed more like an obligation. Brought me to this house because, as he said, he felt... There. He felt it was the right... Stay up there. Right thing to do. He doesn't like to talk about himself, but apparently he has blood of monsters and men on his hands. I don't care. He's wise and... God, would you stay up until I move the mouse away? He's wise and humble, and I wish I could be less of a burden to him. Okay, now I'm done reading it. Anyway. No, I'm not. I need to learn, but Vates never has time to practice with me. If you've never been a teacher, why did he send me to you? I need someone who actually knows how to... He said, bitch. Sir. I need to manually save that, just in case I forget to screenshot this, because that is great. More teachers need to say that to their asshole kids. Are you done being a dick? Hell no, I'm not done! Oh, come on, you know I'm right! You're not the only one to decide what I do and don't know, Fable. If you keep acting like this in my presence, I'm not going to force myself into giving you more lessons. This conversation's over. I need to take care of my bread beer. Say hello to Vates for me. You want to open the door, but you hear Nalia quietly saying your name as if she's not sure whether to call you. Yes, Auntie. We know you're trying your best. Everyone has some learning limits. Feeling guilty about it won't help you. Whatever. I'm just gonna scoot on out of here. Enough studying for now. Yeah, whatever that study session was. It's just reading and writing, and it's boring and tiresome even. I have to be focused all the time. Yep, that is definitely a problem. Told you it'd be a shitty task to take on yourself. But remember how I was going to speak with Lita. Okay, who is Lita? I tried to understand why is she so upset all the time, but now I think even she doesn't know the reason. We used to play a lot when she was a kid. I am not that fast of a reader. It's funny to see how close she got with the Fabulous Stabulous now. Oh, this is Stabulous. Stabulous. When he moved here 4 years ago, I was still a child, yet we bonded really fast. Taylor told us we're like brothers, and even though it's silly, That is seriously going to bug me. I like to think there's something to it. Stabby likes listening to people in his tavern. Tasty Claw. Not done. Tasty Claw is a perfect place for him. It's hard to believe he's not from here. I feel like he's an essential part of Windy Meadow. Some would say he's fabulous. Looks like she's not going to work for me for long. She plans to learn another trade, though I promised I'd keep the details to myself. Wait, this she, is she one of the other two characters? Well, that sucks, but how is this related to me? So you should start coming every now and then. Evenings would be best. You could learn how to run my business. Wait, that's nice, but don't be silly. Can you imagine me bringing a beer to someone? I would spill half of it before I could reach a table. And how would I clean up such a big place? Are you nuts? Man, this guy gives up easily. You dumbass! I'm already visualizing myself editing Super Milk Chan into the video portion of this, the video version of this. How do you want to live as a bard when your imagination is so earthbound? Hey, I like that game. If you can't do some of the physical work, you hire people to help you out, you dumbass. Meanwhile, you need to keep the business spinning, talk to people, decide what to buy or what to make. Give your place a good reputation, you dumbass. Keep the business spinning. What does that even mean? Running. That's what we used to say in the city. Oh, the city is colored. Let's see how quickly I can get through this. Fates took me to Beardus only once, and after a week, this place gave me a headache. There is so much going on. So many people come and go every day. So many things to do. But there is also so loud I couldn't hear my own thoughts. But I guess it didn't reach this area. Well, as you said, I want to be a bard. That means I need to spend time reading stories and making some of my own. And writing them down is going to set me above many traveling talkers. And you think you wouldn't hear more than plenty of stories working here? Well, he's not wrong. Bards come to taverns to listen about people's lives and to sing legends from distant lands. For a storyteller, there's no better place to be. You meet interesting folks and listen to their problems. You hear news, jokes, and rumors from the entire province. If you really want to gather tales and stories, come work with me. Well, it's clearly not this option, because the game established that he wanted to be a barter. Not barter, bard. This feels like the safe choice. It actually sounds pretty good. Give me a couple more days. I need to think about it. I knew you'd notice the opportunity. You should ask Vates before you make up your mind. He's a smart guy. Well, why can't you decide for yourself? Why can't he decide for himself? Well, if you need to hire someone soon, I'm your man. I don't need to talk to anybody. Who is this? He dropped his wealth and moved here from the city to have a simple, pleasant life. How many people can do such a thing? 1 in 1,000? It must be weird to have everything. Oh my goodness, I actually made it through before the message went away. Oh, are you going somewhere? I have to start cleaning the tavern soon. Oh. Sword? Why does a bard need a sword? I do like this. I do like the music. It's very relaxing. Oh, whoops. Okay, good. I can use the wheel on the mouse to scroll back. Why don't you know that the sword is? Since this entire blade is black, I bet it's something magical. When I asked my aunt about it, she just said it's a sword. Black sword. Huh. You know, the last time I saw a black sword was in The Mandalorian, and that black sword, it's nothing but trouble. Spoiler alert. Just a sword my ass, it's the Oathkeeper! Wait a minute. That's a damn Keyblade! The Oathkeeper? Yeah, people actually name their weapons. Like, I bet Stabulous has his own sword. Stabby McStabface. So what's special about this sword? It was made out of cold iron, an ore that was believed to need almost lethal frost to be forged. Only right before the war with the southern tribes, some alchemists discovered that insanely high temperatures can melt it as well. Some cities, like Beard... Did I already do this one? Yeah, I did. have huge iron works, which can produce that much heat, but it takes a tremendous amount of fuel. Foreshadowing, maybe? That's where the Oathkeeper was made, a weapon that never breaks, never gets blunt, never loses its balance, and is no heavier than a usual sword. One of the paintings I have in the common room were meant to portray a sword made of cold iron, but I don't think it's that accurate. You want to read some books when you have stories just waiting for you. Yeah. So tell me, Stabby, another time. Did I already do this one? Oh, no, I didn't. I worked on her farm for a bit. She breeds sheep for meat and griffins for company, but I think all her animals are terrifying. Wait. Sheep? Uh-huh. See ya, runt. Yeah, have an... Really? Wait, he's not riding on anything. I just noticed that. Are his legs broken? Want a sandwich? A fish sandwich. Okay. Nom 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 nom. How was your day? Slow. I'm too busy eating. Mr. Smart Guy, you're so smart. Oh, wait, no, he is writing something. Right here, there's a little cart that he uses. But he didn't use it when he was inside, so his legs must have been broken during the prologue. Oh, hold on, I didn't read that. Apart from the basic chores, I need you to gather our clothes and check them for bugs. Uh-huh. Yeah, sure, whatever. Oh, whoops. I want to create stories, and Victus's life is already a story, a walking proof that it's better to be a bard than a tragic hero. He was always kind to me and ready to... Stop it. And ready to give me an advice if I asked for it. So I used to babysit his daughter quite a lot. Now I can't hold my tears whenever I see her in a never-ending dream. Aw, sweet. Maybe. But what about his job at the tavern? Castus? Thanks to his great beehives, his family lives comfortably. They often hire me to help them with various tasks. Aren't you forgetting something, Fable? Kato Shoujo reference. Stop whatever it is you're doing. We need to talk. Wait, what happened? Oh, yeah, that argument. Yeah. What argument? What are you talking about? Oh, okay. At least I think I understand. No matter what you feel, you are not going to face any special treatment for strangers, you dumb... Excuse you, bitch? Oh, I'm speaking up. How dare you? Oh, you're not even going to let me talk? Change the topic into some cookie recipe? I find that hard to believe. In this? You're gonna make him do it all right now, aren't you? I have nothing to say to you after that. Hey, I was told to cook all that, you old bag. It's my cat. But what about lurking at the tavern? Here's a story you think is interesting and read it out loud. Oh, okay. After that, you're going to tell me what it was about. And after that, we're going to talk about it. Ooh, fairy tales. What can I choose from? I already marked three of them. Oh, how convenient! Three is the only one you can do in a visual novel. Okay, the first one is an old fairy tale, The Ever-Waiting City, as people call it. It's about a king from a faraway land, or rather, about his disloyal architects and subjects. I bought these parchments from an old bard when I was still a young mercenary. Follow the bookmark to find the second text. It's probably also just a story, but it may hold a seed of truth as well. It's a journal written by a traveling monk. He was fascinated by the southern tribes and claimed that he met a small nation that used to believe that everyone was dying at every dusk, and everyone was being reborn at every sunrise. It's part of a larger book, but I think only this one passage was interesting. Years ago, my daughter bound this torn away chapter for my birthday. Not only a nice gift, but it actually protected these pages from destruction. It may be the only copy in existence. The last one is something like a legend. I'm not sure how to describe it. It's about this rich man who lived alone in a forest. One day a mysterious creature came by and tried to befriend him. I won't spoil the rest. Oh, okay. I wrote down this tale myself after hearing it from an old faraway inn. Well, I'm definitely not reading this one then. Just saying it right now. I'm not picking that last one. Definitely the monk's tale. The monk's tale sounds the most interesting. Whenever the full moon rose upon the village of flowers, I asked a shaman to let me live with her tribe and learn its ways. And every time, no matter the answer, she greeted me with the words, "Welcome, stranger. What are you buying?" So tell me what you remember from this story. It made me interested in the background of this monk. He seems to be a smart fellow. You'd be disappointed. At first, many scholars praised his journal, but when the authorities from the Church of Truth, there's an oxymoron if I have seen one. Wow, the Church of Truth. Huh, and there's the Oathkeeper. Apparently, the major part of it was proven to be either wrong or deceitful. Again, no surprise coming from the Church of Truth. The author was forced to stay in a monastic cell for many years and pray for wisdom and forgiveness. How do you know all this? I was pretty dumb when I was young. We were all dumb when we were young. Whatever. But the older I got, the more interested in books I started to be. This monk's covenant was set in Burtis? Okay, and I spent most of my life there. I see. Right. Yeah. Anyway, something about the flower tribe. Whenever you fall asleep, you die, and whenever you wake, you're reincarnated. That's what she told you, though. How did this tribe come up with this belief? The shaman tried to explain this by describing some of the past events. She started more foreshadowing, I think. She started with the forgotten memories of the past, but mostly focused on times when people completely changed their personality with the passage of time. She said, it's impossible to understand how our past could ever be reality. Even a single day can give birth to a new world. Am I too young to understand this, or is this just silly? Good storytellers can't write tales only for people who share their experiences. Let's call it an empathy lesson. According to the journal, people from this nation were treating this topic with full seriousness, and it affected their everyday life. They treated each other as strangers every day. They considered old offenses irrelevant. Words as love or friendship were believed to be pointless and vain. Grudge, a soul's flaw. They seized the day, but often in quite short-sighted ways, without thinking about the consequences. Even though they were using a language that the monk was partially familiar with, they used a lot of strange phrases. My favorite one was how they greeted even their family members. Let's die together! And what about the actual death? How did they compare these everyday deaths to passing away? For what I understand, it was like taboo. They never cried after the deceased and just dropped the bodies in a valley for the wolves to devour. Okay, then. Yeah, that sounds lovely. Jackals. I don't know what that is. I'll ask someone to draw it for you later. So I guess it's everything? Fine. And what do you think it was actually all about? Oh. I'd probably say a description. Of course you would say that. Oh, no, that was a good story. So we'll see each other in... Yeah, sure. Yeah, I'm gonna go. I don't have time for that old bastard. Bye. Okay, so if I have my legs, I'm dreaming. Clearly. Yep. To jump. To fall. To stand. Oh, what's going to happen? What? What does the map do? Oh, interesting. Fable! I'm here! Boy. Very timely quote here for all the wrong reasons. A pack of goblins migrated to our forest. Ooh, okay. Are they going to attack? Nah, we'll be ready. If you describe this great hunter without mentioning all of his flaws, he would bring to mind heroes from songs and legends. Most people focus on his great achievements. I knew it was going to fade away. And the animal trophy's hanging in his house, so he's Gaston. Yeah, he's Gaston. Has to be. I guess I am. What about this tavern? I thought we were gonna work there. Well, I'm surprised. He sounds surprised too. So I wanted to ask if you could entertain our guests for some time. Can I get paid for it? Yay! Cool. Well, screw that noise. Who is it? Hi. Am I late? Some nice cotton wicks, yeah. Can we not talk about Vates for 1 minute? How am I doing? None of your beeswax. Could be better, could be worse. I don't know a thing about books. There's another one I have to save. But hey, he could write his name. Can you? I don't feel like being a dick. Everything under control. Field crops spell nice. No, they don't. Yes, they do. No, they don't. Yes, they do. Dragons! Our coins are made of dragon bones. Oh, wow. No wonder that money is so rarely used. Interesting. Interesting that dragon bones would be your currency. Apparently, yes. Yeah, it would. Oh, yeah, let's tell the story, sure. Bravely bold Sir Robin rode forth from Camelot. In a small village where the hero lives, in an exotic castle, in the middle of a battle. Well, the battle would probably be the most exciting one. The victory was right in front of them. What forces your hero to start an adventure? So, Final Fantasy, Dragon Age, Dragon Quest. You know what? That Endwalker expansion is coming out, so let's do Final Fantasy. It was clear he couldn't stay there anymore. What stands behind the danger that Hero tries to stop? A monster? Let's see. Behemoth? Tonberry? Well, all of them could. Both of these could be Tonberry. Evil King. But the Evil King was Final Fantasy II, the original Final Fantasy II. We'll go with Monster. The earth was trembling under its paws. What sort of turning point would you like to describe? Okay. Epic battle, an impossible task, a plot twist! Epic battle. The painful scream has torn the sky apart. How should your story end? Leave them wanting more? End it the old-fashioned way? Or turn it into a clomp manga? Clomp? Clamp. Turn it into a clamp manga. Yeah, we're doing that. It was clear what had to be done. It was time to close the eyes. And it looks like he was gonna have to jump! You have nothing to add. You take a deep breath and turn toward your audience. Damn right, it was interesting! Yeah, that was fun. I took some inspiration from here and there. Ha! See? And just when I was enjoying the music, dude, this is a nice score. Oh, what does this idiot want? Wait, what is... Oh no, they're being attacked! Alright, fine. Let's go. The forest is on fire. The goblins are going to lose their mind, yeah. Ooh. Those goblins, yikes. Are you sure about that? What if she refuses, though? Alright. Open up, bitch! Wake up! I'm respecting your privacy by knocking on the door, but I am asserting my authority as the one boy that can save you by coming in anyway. Oh, shit! What did she do? Did she get plastered? at it! Get at it! Come on, let's go! No, 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 don't fade out! What happened? Did Auntie make it out? It better not have been fantastic. So I guess we're not gonna see what happened? Everything is a story. Well, I certainly would love to know what kind of story happened last night. Yeah, it could be worse. But what happened, though? Yeah. You condescending jerk. I loved three things in life. Flowers, moon, and flowers. The common church doesn't have much in common with us. No pun intended. He's even aware. Then they die in vain. Do I have a choice? No, I want to be a bard. Okay, Auntie lived. Great. See ya. I said see ya. Well, when are we going to talk about it? Okay, I guess we're not going to talk about it. I would love to know what happened last night, too, as the player. Okay. I may be young, but I'm not stupid. Is this really the time, though? Are you scared? Oh yeah, kind of. Yeah, something tells me that this path is not going to end well. It's going to end with them entering our streets. Narrative voice. Most monsters will know how to dig. I hope you gave it just to one of the two other protagonists. It's just such a bizarre dynamic between everybody right now. Can I just go around telling stories? The singing bards. What, do they memorize everything? I think I understand. No, okay, I agree with her. You can't just retell the other stories. You need to be creative and transform them. You also have to be expressive and excited and learn to emote when telling these stories. Yeah. Why did the music stop? Just listen to the boy. Yeah, they do want a performance. Because, I mean, even if you can't get behind the story that the bard is telling, you could at least vibe to the bard's performance, right? A good dancer with a lute can sing some rhyming bullshit about cute girls for a drunken crowd and leave them with a purse of dragon coins. Well, she's not entirely wrong. Because people are stupid. Be a performer instead. This could also imply to let's play videos. Use your gestures. Use your voice to keep an audience interested. How to select the right tone.
How to select the right tone.
How to select the right tone. It's not a choice between an important message and a fun time. If you want people to care, you have to make them care. Don't expect, act. You can't give someone an apple and tell them to make a pie out of it. Drink. It doesn't matter. I'm not you. Oh, okay. She actually does raise some legitimate points about performance. The art of performing. There's so much to storytelling than just reading. Even when playing games, there's more to expressing how you feel than just reading and processing. Something I have to remind myself almost every time I play a game and record it. Determination! The secret word of the day! Bread beer. I bet, yeah, you would drink a bunch of it. The Gargoyle Slayer. Let me tell you a real story. Oh. Oh, wait, there's more chapters. Oh, wait, no, there's not more chapters. Alright, so we have finished. We have finished his story. Now, the herbalist, the best huntress in Windy Meadow. That, I am sold on this one. What a title. Hopefully this doesn't end in gruesome death. I mean, this doesn't begin in gruesome death. Vina follows in her father's footsteps. Kind words, but trust me, she already outmatched almost every hunter in this province, and she's not even 20. She's young and sweet, only 17? This is probably what I would choose as well. Move to the city. Oh, yeah. Maybe. Well, can't I answer the question, bitch? Okay. Move on up. Sounds interesting. Yeah. Back. What about the warrior? Can we talk about the warrior? Oh, this is a nice background. But you're going to anyway, aren't you? Well, yeah, you actually do need to know to make a good choice. You don't want to not know and end up making a bad choice. Yeah, well, I don't like your nut. But I had plans. Now, since I have caught your attention... No. Okay. Yeah, trolls are crazy. Tasty scrumptious rodents. Don't suppose we can eat that owl up of us, can we? I don't want to guess. I'm indecisive. I don't think. Yeah, this is sounding a little complicated already. Holy shit, it's heavy. Looks delicious, too. Oh, you don't like me saying shit? Well, I'm so goddamn sorry, man. I didn't mean to offend you with my shitty language. This shit is gonna taste so well after smoking. That would be shitty, well, wouldn't it? Yeah, let's do our shitty prayer then. Dear Lord, thank you for letting us live long enough to enjoy this great gift of your creation. Help us stay wise so that we can share this meat with our shitty family and friends. We'll be sure to share with our dear Vate some of the coins we're going to get for these trunks. She's not even praying! Because we want to stay humble in your light and to prove you that if you ever need us to do so... We're ready to leave everything behind, even our shitty lives. I have nothing to say. I have nothing to say in response to your shit. Praying's overrated. Yeah, not everyone can be a priest. Everyone has a different path. Not everyone can be a priest. Priests need someone hunting for them as well, right? Oh, this is a good thing we didn't get to choose this guy among the three protagonists. Let's see. I want you to look here on the ground. Do you know what that is? It's shit. A goblin tried to hunt the board. Well, that goblin did a shitty job, didn't he? I don't want to touch the blood! You crazy? We're just gonna leave the boar behind? I guess we're gonna leave that boar behind. Oh no, it's right here. Yay, we completed a monster hunt. Or a mage. Who's mom? My mom is the master of crossbows and traps. She made an unstoppable couple of fighters with my dad, and it's soul-crushing to see her spending 3 years in bed because of some illness. I'm afraid that even if she recovers from it, she may never be able to enter the wilderness in a way she used to. Oh, that sucks. No. Well, there's still threats. I gotta say, that is a really cool looking statue right there. Oh, geez, and the lighting. I wasn't paying that much attention. The lighting that's reflecting on this 1632-bit shadow, the statue, that is very impressive. What was the? Are you going to get rid of them before you leave us? Leave? Okay. Go back. I'm not leaving you. Yeah, that seems like a good choice. Does he now? Who is our youngest sister, at least the youngest one alive? I keep hearing rumors about her antics, but whenever I spend time with her, she's submissive and quiet. She wants to be a hunter and often asks me for advice and tips, but why doesn't she talk more with our father? More experienced than her? Me? So be ready! Yeah! We will not be held back by our fathers! Actually, I want to keep it on this because this is so relaxing. This music with the rain. This is nice. This is relaxing. This is definitely one of the coziest soundtracks to a visual novel I've heard. Oatmeal and gruel for every meal. Wow, that does sound boring. Little to what? Wait, what? Go back. No, I don't want to know yet. Oatmeal, cold winters, little to no music. Well, hey, the music isn't so bad. It's minimalist, and sometimes minimalist is perfect. I love you, sis. Don't let Dad hold us back. Who's there? Move her ass, kid! Brackus. Oh, hello. We don't need him. Brackus. The mayor. Get lectures on wild monsters. At least they're not as tough as trolls. Yeah, but do you have a priest? Priest wannabe that tells you that saying shit is annoying? What about... Oh, okay, never mind. Are you sure that's a good idea? Did you really have to bring that up? Well, congratulations. You wouldn't be saying that in today's economy. What's the matter? Huh? Oh boy. Twenty. Damn. Well, let's see what we are having for dinner then. I see drinks. So be it. I like so be it as the alternative to amen. Boar. Yay. Can I have me too? Oh, so 16 is the legal age here in Windy Meadow. Got it. I know kids die every... Wow. She's rude and weird. Dad is right. I'm kidding. You would. You little priest wannabe, you would. Let someone's beliefs dictate your decisions, wouldn't you? Uh, Yep, he sure did. If at all I can stance, I can't stands no more. Yeah, I did. I did it, and I'd f***ing do it again. Yeah, there's so many possibilities. You can't just afford to lie. Leave this to... Oh, okay. Leave it to the grown-ups, huh? Oh, I owe you? Man, these scene changes seem rather abrupt. He's a lumberjack and he's okay. That's okay. Man, these families, they're so vulgar to their kin. Oathkeeper! Well, too bad. You accept it. You take it. It's a good sword, apparently. I don't think she needs booze, any more of it. See ya. Hooray. When will they attack? They might attack next month. They might attack next week. They might attack tomorrow. So you might as well start panicking right now, I guess, if they can attack at any time. Don't laugh while you're feeling like this. Who is a hero these days? Well, of course you would say that. You and your biased opinions. About everything. But most importantly, the tasty claw. But you're not... thank you. I was just about to say. Yeah, they could attack tomorrow or next week or next month. Allegedly. Be happy. There might be death along the way, but you'll be happy, right? In your work. Or you could stay here, protect those that you love, but not make as much money. Whatever you do, do it, and be happy with your decision. That strong young body, huh? Nom 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 nom. The fabulous Stabulous showed her some new tricks. Unless they learn how to dig a hole. Stabby, stabby, stabby. Oh, shut up. Shut up with your verses. I mean, they could still attack next month, you said. Not tomorrow. Well, who cares how I bathe myself? Who cares? Because we're amazing, and you, ma'am, are apparently the world's greatest huntress. That's what the game told me. Stabby, stabby, stabby. No, it was all the work of God, apparently. It's probably what he's thinking. Watching and waiting. Oh boy, oh boy. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Goblins! Daddy? More goblins! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 goblins! Stabby stabby time! Huh? Oh, this is interesting. Stabby! They burninated him. That was cool. That was impressive. Nice, like, graphic novel telling. What? Uh-huh. And? Oh, no. They went to Windy Meadow. Okay, what were the options? Run to the... Okay, we got that. Run to the village, wake up anyone you can. I'm going... Let's split up, gang. And again, we're not gonna see what happened, what transpired. Well, yeah, what about it? What about it, Mr. Then? No. Inaudible, huh? Rada, 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 rada. I said, rada 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 rada. What do you think he should have done instead? Maybe you could have joined in the hunt instead of bitching at all of us. Yeah, you couldn't tell us before. Yeah, the tasty claw! Wait, what happened? Is this really happening? Well, guess what? I've had all I can stand. I can't stand no more. Shut up, Dad. I'm trying to defend you. No, don't fade out. Oh, sure you can. Just set up a tent. Oh, I guess we won't. Drink much? Flock, not herd. Is this really the time for all this crap? You dumbass! Yeah, this absolutely is the time for this. Oh ho ho ho! Trying to work here! You made me throw my spear! My only spear! You scared it when you threw that spear in, Edgar. The fabulous Stabulous proposed to me! And I said, yes, I'm gonna be Mrs. Stabby now. What a weird time to bring that up out of the blue. And that's all I've got to say about it. Yeah, congratulations. Congratulations. He's a stabby keeper. Yeah, gotta go with the realistic choice. I'm sorry, girl. And that route is done. I'm not really sure I'm feeling the pacing on these stories so far. Seems abrupt almost, but maybe this will change. This will change my mind. And then the final chapter. 12 years ago. Oh no, are we gonna see more death? Who's there? In my age, it's almost sleeping hours. The sun hasn't even set all the way. You drugged her! Ew. Is she cursed? Is she dumb? It's not a curse, you dumbass! So she grew out of the Play-Doh. Well, maybe, she's a little shy and not cursed. Thank you! Okay, finally, we got some realism here. She's... Oh, wait, I read that completely wrong. She is not normal. She needs a special type of care and upbringing. Yeah, she should be raised by me. You two get the hell out of here. I'm going to smack you so hard you won't ever need anodyne for your teeth again. I'm loving this prologue already. Or you could just leave and abandon her before she wakes. Lying in bed is boring and life is too short for it. Oh, whoops. Anyway. How much did it cost? None of your beeswax. Bye-bye. Dot, dot, dot. Ooh, wow. That's kind of a foreboding. Oh, geez, that got... Yikes. So... Parent talk is a little triggering, I see. Even the music stopped. I don't like children. Yikes. It's a little terrifying. And we progress. Okay. Yay, walking! We need to go walkies! Mushroom hunting! No, I just don't like children. And my parents, apparently. But I like you. Your parents. Why? Oh, wow. Oh, okay. I don't want to force you into being. You stop right there. Just stop right there. Bro, she is going to smack you. And again, the music stops right when the parents are brought up. You really did not just say that, did you? God, you are... Ladies and gentlemen, we got a dumb boy right here saying some of the stupidest shit I have seen since I played Season of the Sakura. Deal with it, yeah. Patient, he says. There's a moose. Anyway. No, no, you don't get to hug me after that. Yeah, keep smirking at you, me asshole. Yeah, let's go. Let us never speak of this again, husband. This is an interesting story path right now. And? Yeah, I remember. Got anything else? Just as long as you don't mention the parents. All this thunder. I definitely like the rain effect that the designers used for this game. Never imagined rain to be so peaceful sounding. Anyway, you're not old, so... Her parents! Her parents. Damn right. Well, that's how I work. And the better change. Or else I'll take this giant pot and cook them in it. Deep breath. Let's go. There's a griffin! Come on, girl. Well, she does strike me as being brutally honest, so it'd be kind of out of character for her to lie right now. Mm-hmm. Well, see ya. Oh, is this the trap shed from the previous story? Limos. Good diet and healthy lifestyle kept limos. I'm looking at these two and kind of remind me of Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa if they aged together. Why are you celebrating? Yeah, you should come visit. Let her stick it to you. Bye, dudes. Oh, shut up. You silly. Yeah, it doesn't work that way. Sorry. Goblins, yeah, let me tell you about those goblins. Fire. Hi there, two things. We're supplying Stabby, yes. Like I just said, I said go with Evolo. Evolo. Language. Gee, I wonder. I don't know. Good night. Loony Looty, huh? Oh, trauma is so funny, isn't it, you assholes? Anyway. They call Stabula Stabby. Quick save. Yeah, the goblins. Boyfriend? What's a boyfriend? Many secret, huh? And she says with a wink? You two into yep, kinky shit, I knew it! Oh. Oh. Anyway. Yeah, please. Yeah, we're not into that. That's okay. Some are into it, some aren't. What are you, 12? Lame answer. Typo. Typo, typo. So I'm gonna do this one. Wow. Oh, tonight is gonna end horribly. Damn it, you said the trigger words. Why would you do that? No. Absolutely nothing comes to mind. No. Of course not. No. It's a chocobo. Answer. Because of the goblins. That are about to strike. Screwed each other. Thank you. animal unions. Well, isn't that pleasant? Click. Or too small. What? Just like the goblins that are right outside the backyard. Since you're the only one that doesn't talk about, you know, them. Do you answer my question? Because you never had a family? Oh, yeah. Is this some sort of I don't want you to repeat the mistakes I've made? Enough speaking around the riddles, what are you saying? Huh, interesting. Interesting way of looking at it. It's platonic. Screw everyone else. Are you sure about that? I don't know. How about some cookies? How about some food? What? Cookies are actual food? Oh, cool. Living the rich life. Maybe that's why you got married. You want all that money. And there are the goblins. 3, 2, 1, go. You know, the fire from the goblins? Anyway, just focus on... Do we even need to take clothes? Nah. Miss Candy. Oh, we're actually gonna keep going with the evening. The entire story. That was missing from the other two paths. Those damned goblins. A hug! He earned a hug, yay! Oh, that does not look good. Damn! He was trained by Auntie. Phrasing. What'd you find? Excuse me. Well, yeah, almost. Oh, no. Oh! Oh. Well, that got interesting. Interesting little plot twist. What do I choose here? I'm gravitating towards this one. Pride. So he's a ghostwriter. Or maybe you could talk to a bard. Anyway, whoops, I picked the most awkward choice. Well, sleep. I'd rather die outside than die in bed. And I want you to know that I don't give a damn what you say. Oh, yeah, that too. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Why are their eyes yellow? Oh my God. What have you done? I can't choose. Well, she didn't like her friend calling her that, so you would expect her to snap if her parents called her that, so I'll go with that. And the music got eerie all of a sudden. Well, yeah, I would. Oh! I will never forgive that they abandoned me. I don't have a family. Oh, my. Yikes! I get the feeling that it doesn't matter what I choose here, but whatever. Oh, no. Wow. Okay, last chapter. We're gonna tie all this together somehow. And all these people in there, yeah, it get a lot hotter in there. Stabby. Do 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 do. I can't stand this anymore. Yeah, they might come tomorrow, next week, or next month. Let's play a game. Yay, let's let the bard tell a story. I can do it. Let's do it. Let's tell a story. Can we not with the fatso jokes? Let's do something fun. What is fun about a necromancer? Okay. How is that the fun choice? I guess they're entertained, I think. Was that a horn or a fart? And Inferma's got gas. Oh, you are not going to make her stay. Is this really the time to be talking about proving yourself? So he's gonna do it. He's probably gonna die. That's too bad. Answer. Oh, did the battle already his arm! His arm! Man, all these exciting battles and we don't get to see any of it. Hooray, I guess? Right now? Yeah, my thoughts exactly. Oh, hey, you can still do stuff with one arm. You're tough, you'll adapt. I'm moving. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, we do need to talk. Ah, man. This one is tough. On one hand, yeah, I see she doesn't want to be controlled by anyone else. She doesn't want to have to share anything about her horrid life with anybody. But she did open up to him. I mean, there is clearly some sort of chemistry between the two of them. I mean, she deserves to be happy with everything she's been through. Maybe he can give that to her, after all? It's tricky. It's tricky to ponder these things. Like, is she gonna be miserable by herself, shunning away everyone? Or will she potentially be miserable with him? Neither seems like a good ending for her, really. What does history have to say? How far back can I go? Can I at least go to... the last time they spoke? Oh, yeah, yeah. They were gonna write that book. Him and Salvia. I hope I made the right choice with her. Well, we gotta make the place look nice. We don't want them to think that we're serving ogre blood, don't we? Not entirely true. Exactly. Tales from Sleepy Meadow now. Well, good. I'm glad you felt that way. Glad someone is entirely happy. Hooray! Oh, okay. I thought I told you that, yeah. That I could do it. Be a bard, or help you? Help the stabby. Well, yeah, he did say that the tavern would be the best place to learn about stories. Would be a good jumping point, good starting point, so let's start at the tavern. You'll make some incredible stories at the Tasty Crab. I mean, the Crusty Crab, the Tasty Claw, yeah. Smart small, and then build into one of the greatest bards in the world. Oh, the interface faded. Did we reach the end? 1 week later. Oh, the end? Oh, or not, no. I guess. Happy day. Here comes the bride, leaving the trauma behind. Well, there you go. That's how you gotta look at it. I don't hate them. I just hate the thought of having children of my own. Yeah. Indeed. The boring adult topics. True, very true. It's another one I wanna archive. Yeah, age is just a number. Ain't that cute?
But it's wrong!
Yep, bye everybody! Yeah, I just yelled it outside, right into her window. Poisonous fungi want to be forged at any cost. Poisonous fungi want to be forged. Green perennial cuts your hands like a razor. Bogs try to sell their carpets to anyone. The clearing gets black from all this poison. Cowbanes and hellbores keep smiling at you. The forest is silent and gentle. That's it. Okay, I guess that's it. And here we see the picture. Is that the Seattle needle? Anyway, I guess we get to see the pictures of everyone living their lives. Seems all right. Very nice, relaxing music. Ren P, of course it was. Thank you for visiting Windy Meadow. Nope. That's it. Okay, then. I guess that was it. Oh, whoops. Felt like there were still some things left unanswered. Or, not sure. Yeah, it's like I was saying earlier, the pacing seemed a little drastic at times, but it's still enjoyable. I mean, the aesthetic looks great. Why I was drawn to this in the first place, and the music is relaxing. Her story, yeah, might be my favorite of the three because of the way it was told and how it dealt with trauma. But if she's married and happy, did she put the trauma with her parents behind her? It's really tough to say. But I'm calling it a clear, though, because there doesn't seem to be any other indication that I had a bad ending, or a good ending, or any archive of progress like I got with Starlight Shores. That's fine, though. I'll take the clear. Next time, the final game of this season. I am one game away from getting a complete, undisputed, 100% clear of a season. And it happens to be the Oregon Trail, which also happens to be Gauntlet number 50. Lot riding on that one. So until next time, this has been Nitro, the one they call M-Disc. Good night and have a pleasant tomorrow.